Though Dragon Ball Super did not have the strongest start, I think the show redeemed itself with its final two arcs. All in all, despite its flaws, I love this series. And today, I will be presenting my top 10 moments from Dragon Ball Z's true sequel series. And in today's video, I will be giving you my top 10 moments from Dragon Ball Super. Coming in at number 10, we have Goku and Vegeta's first discovery of Super Saiyan Blue. Even though I really didn't like the first two arcs of Super because they were basically just rehashes of the movies, I do like this little bit thrown in during the Golden Frieza arc because we actually got to see how the Super Saiyan Blue transformation was achieved, making it feel earned. As opposed to the Resurrection F movie where it was really just transformation for the sake of transformation. One of the reasons I don't like Super Saiyan Blue. If I'm being honest, out of all the Super Saiyan forms, Super Saiyan Blue is my least favorite. But over time, I have developed a bit of an appreciation for it. Though, I will admit, Super Saiyan Blue does look cool. That's literally all it has going for it in my book. In the Goku Black arc, we are once again reintroduced to one of the series' most popular characters, and one of my personal favorites, Future Trunks. In this arc, his world is under threat once again by a ruthless enemy who bears the same face as Son Goku. This reveal creates an aura of mystery as to the true identity of this new foe. This reveal was executed to nigh perfection. The destroyed city landscape, the eerie, haunting music, a truly perfect foreshadowing for what was coming next. And what came next made me drop my drink. Every time I rewatch that scene, it gives me chills, thus earning it the number 9 spot. Number 8, Vegeta goes beyond Super Saiyan Blue. Throughout the run of Dragon Ball Z, ever since the Namek arc, Vegeta had been trying his damnedest to catch up to Goku.
Is that a fact? Mind your tongue.
But in Dragon Ball Super, that all changes. It's no longer the one-sided rivalry we saw in Z. Now, they are more like equals. Nowadays, Vegeta looks to become stronger in his own way. And this is exemplified when Vegeta achieves a level beyond Super Saiyan Blue, complete with a design that is more reminiscent of his Super Saiyan Grade 2 or Super Vegeta form, complete with spikier hair and increased muscle mass. To be honest, I just call this form Super Vegeta Blue. What makes this transformation even more unique is that that is Vegeta's own unique form. One he obtained his way. Number 7. Goku vs. Hit. The rematch. This was hands down one of my favorite pieces of filler from the entire series. Yes, surpassing Goku's fight with PyCon in the Otherworld tournament. We had been waiting for a long time for the titanic rematch between the best fighters of two universes, and even though it was a filler episode, we got it. And damn, it was good. Earning it, spot number 7. Number 6. Vegeta teams up with Goku against Jiren. Both Goku and Vegeta had put their best foot forward to try and take on the Titan Jiren. The former twice, but their best efforts had come up short. Yet, as proud as they are, they realized that the best chance they had against Jiren was to work together. And for a while, it seemed as though that was the breakthrough that they needed, and it seemed like victory could be attained. Though that proved to not be the case, seeing the champions of the Saiyan race fight together as opposed to taking turns for a change was a refreshing change of pace and a real thrill to watch. Shows us that when it really counts, these two really can work together. Number 5, the return of Vegito. This was the moment we were all waiting for. After Goku Black and Zamasu fused, we knew what was coming next. Sure, the Vegito fight was short-lived, even more so in the manga, but it was a beautiful spectacle to watch. Separately, Goku and Vegeta could barely land a blow on Zamasu. But when they merged together into Vegito, oh, he was kicking Zamasu's ass through and through. I have not seen a curb stomping this legendary since Vegito's fight with Super Buu. And the icing on the cake was getting to see Vegito use the final Kamehameha. Though that didn't actually destroy Zamasu, it was still really damn cool to watch. Earning it the number 5 spot. Let's move on to number 4. Number 4. Trunks defeats merged Zamasu. Throughout this arc, Trunks had been repeatedly outshined by Goku, Vegeta, and of course, Goku Black. But he finally got his moment when he struck the final blow to the merged menace that had been terrorizing his timeline. It was the perfect way to end what is still my favorite arc in Dragon Ball Super. Number 3. The Awakening of Ultra Instinct. The moment the series had been building up to. And when Goku emerged from the crater created by the Spirit Bomb, we were all left in awe. What could this have been? And then as we see Goku fight in this new form, Beerus confirms it.
Autonomous Ultra Instinct.
And the musical accompaniment was perfect. Though if you ask me, the Japanese version was better. Though this first taste of Ultra Instinct was short-lived, this was undoubtedly a high point in the Tournament of Power. Number 2. The Father-Son Kamehameha. It was an awesome callback to the original Father-Son Kamehameha from the Cell games. And that's about all I have to say about it. Number 1.
It's triple, quadruple. No, it's time!
Yes, in my opinion, this was the best moment in all of Dragon Ball Super. We've seen Goku push past his limits time after time, but this way was truly special. Combining Super Saiyan Blue with Kaioken. Need I say more? This was truly a plus ultra moment. And that is why it is my favorite. Alright, that's all I got for today's video. I'd like to thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit that like button. And while you're at it, why not press subscribe and click the bell icon so you can stay notified whenever it is I upload a new video. Alright, this is Artas Vadam signing out.